All right, Shalom. I'd like to start off by saying Barakathe Yahawa. Barakathe Yahawa Shai. Barakathe Yahawa Ba'ashim Yahawa Shai. Double honors to the elders and apostles of Great Millstone. And enough respect to the brothers that are out there pushing and spreading the truth, you know, this word, to the four corners of the world. Through the spirit and power of Yahawa Ba'ashim Yahawa Shai, you know, I found this video. And, you know, today being, you know, the day of Thanksgiving, I just want to bring this out and pull out a couple of scriptures, you know, and keep pushing the word. So.
I know something I won't tell, I won't tell, I won't tell. I know something I won't tell.
What you know, huh?
Well, it's just that Injun Joe is a ticklish.
No! Stop! Cut it out! Anything else! Oh, no!
America became the great nation she is today, thanks to brave men like these.
Shucks, see, it weren't nothing.
Habakkuk chapter 2, verse 5. Ye also, because he transgresseth by wine, he is a proud man, neither keepeth at home, who enlarges his desires hell, and it says death, and cannot be satisfied, but gathereth unto him all nations, and heapeth unto him all people. Shall not all these take up a parable against him, and a taunting prophet against him, and say, woe to him that increases that which is not his? How long, and to him that laid himself thick with clay? Jump to verse 12. Woe to him that buildeth a town with blood and establish a city by iniquity. Proverbs chapter 22, verse 8. Well, matter of fact, go to Isaiah. Verse 1. Woe to thee that spoileth, and thou wast not spoiled. Right? So it says, okay, and dealest treacherously, and they dealt not treacherously with thee. When thou shalt cease to spoil, thou shalt be spoiled. And when thou shalt make an end to deal treachery, they shall deal treacherously with thee. An eye for an eye. Okay, it says, woe unto you, think everything is good for you. You have spoiled. You have dealt treacherously, right? It says, woe unto you, you thinking that you have done it and thou was not spoiled. You think that because you've done it and it has not been done to you yet, you think that you're free? Nah, man, it's not how it works. When you are ceased to spoil, all right, because right now people are under the curses right now. When that curse is stopped, when the Lord decides, all right, that's enough, thou shalt be spoiled. We're going to do the same thing you did. The scripture said we're going to do double to what you did to us. And when thou shalt make an end to deal treachery, they shall deal treacherously with thee. Okay? Proverbs 22, verse 8. He that soweth iniquity shall reap iniquity, and the rod of his anger shall fail. Right? But let's just get into Revelation chapter 13, verse 10. And then we end it with that. He that leadeth into captivity shall go into captivity. He that killeth with the sword, here it is, must be killed with the sword. Here is the patience and the faith of the saints. Alright? Look, man, the Most High is now blind. And how disrespectful is it, man? Yo, you all know the history. You all know what it is that happened to them. On the day they met, you know, Christopher Columbus. Or the red people, man. When I say red people, I mean the people that are so-called white people. They're really red. But you all know, like, the history, man. You all know, because it wasn't Thanksgiving. There was no thanks. It wasn't happy Thanksgiving. It was sorrowful. It was lamentation. It was carnage, slaughter, man, genocide. That's what it was. And you, like, there's no way to put it. Like, this should not even be celebrated at all. People have no heart, man. And they hold themselves not accountable, man. It's one thing, yo, leave these Edomites to do their celebration, man. But you Jake's out there, man. You're joined to him, partaking in his feast, man. Look, the Most High will jack you up with them. Because you're fucked up in the mind. That's what's wrong with you. He can't separate you from him. He gotta burn you with him. He gotta take you out with him. Yeah, destruction is coming. Alright? You wanna take you've been taking your judgment and your hell here, and you wanna join yourself to him and take another one? Are you out of your damn mind? But justice is gonna be out there, man. Justice is definitely coming. The Most High is not blind. He's not blind, man. I love the scripture. Psalm 73. Right. Says, therefore, pride compasseth himself about as a chain, Esau, so-called white man. Violence covereth them as a garment. All right. Garment is always on you. That's how violent it is for them. Violence is part of them. Their eyes stand out with fatness. They have more than the heart could wish. They have everything, yet they still want more. Yet they still want to kill. That they still want to steal. Every little thing that you have, they wanna take it. They make a war with the poor. That's what they love to do. Because the fatness of the earth, man, does not make them happy. What makes them happy is the sorrow of people. They get off on that. So you over here, you happy because, you know, you got your meal, your clothes. You're satisfied in life. You have just enough. You happy, you know, because you're content. But they cannot be content. The only time they get off, that's what the scripture says, the soul which is lifted up in them is not upright, man. They are corrupt and speak wickedly concerning oppression. Look at, here it is. You just water down the whole story with something like this, man.
Great nation,
so proud, man. Great nation, but what they don't understand is that there's been a reserved judgment, man. Every little thing that they do, the Most High be like, I'm gonna do this to you. It's been reserved for you. Their pride, man.
Thanks to and so.
They make jokes about it. They make jokes about it.
So America became the great nation she is today.
Thanks to brave men. You feel entitled to this land, and you go to comments.
Shucks,
it's
nothing.
Even him falling is funny. Getting you, I'm being good, my man. Let me do it. Oh man. they set their mouth against the heavens, and their tongue walketh through the earth. And they say, verse 11, how does God know? Is there any knowledge in the Most High? Yes, there is knowledge in the Most High. Behold, these are ungodly, who prosper in the world. They increase in riches. He that leadeth into captivity shall go into captivity. He that killeth with the sword must be killed with the sword. He has the patience and the faith of the saint. And you better believe there is enough Israelites out there that are crying day and night, man. We're going to make the ears of the Most High heavy. We're going to keep praying, man. And the judgment will definitely come. Just keep that in your mind, man. You're going out there, going to celebrate. I hope this ruins it for you. You ain't supposed to be celebrating it. You know, to the Akims that are listening, I want to say Shalom, Barakathay Hawa, Bashem Yahushai, you know, Barakathay, you know, bless you. To the few Akims that are listening, you know, Shalom. And, you know, I'm going to end it right here.